Hey, how's it going? Do you guys remember that time when I decided to move out of my apartment in Florida? Well, update, I don't have a house anymore. I spent all my money on a car and now I'm living out of my car. I actually have no idea where I am right now. I am legitimately homeless, but homeless by choice. Unless you count this car as being a home, then I'm not homeless. It's very cozy. As you can see, this is my bed where the magic happens, as they say. Oh, what is this? It's just a picture with my wife and my kids. I wanted to make the place a little more homey. I definitely didn't go into Target and steal the stock photos they have inside of their pictures. Definitely didn't do that. That would be a really weird thing to do. But yeah, if I'm being honest, in classic Aiden fashion, I don't really have a plan. I kind of just got this car and I'm just going to drive around the U.S. and meet people. And wherever the wind kind of takes me is where I'm going to be going. And then I'll just shoot videos wherever I am. I just wanted to leave. I just couldn't be stuck inside anymore. So
just like that, this was the start of one of the craziest decisions I've ever made. You guys know that cheesy quote, it's something along the lines of, "It's not about the destination, but the adventure along the way." Well, this trip has no final destination, it's literally only about the adventure. And with all that being said, I decided the first place I wanted to go was to see an old friend.
Richard, you son of a bitch.
Richard? I haven't heard that name in years.
This right here is Richard. You may or may not recognize Richard, but he's been in a bunch of my videos. And for some reason, I just never gave Richard a proper introduction on my channel. So here's why Richard is one of the coolest dudes I know. For one, Richard can do these really cool knife tricks that seem terrifying to me. Two, Richard knows how to make these crazy good drinks. He's basically like your own personal bartender. Not only can he make mixed drinks though, he can also make these weird looking shots.
It's pretty good. It slightly tastes like cough syrup. Like slightly.
On top of all that, he's also an elite anonymous hacker.
Who may or may not be planning to hack into the Pentagon to delete all of America's debt, finally setting everyone free from the shackles of financial burden.
He's also a pretty good cook. I mean, they're no dinosaur chicken nuggets, but they're not bad. Seeing Richard was probably the main reason I decided to drive all the way out here, but that also gave me a great excuse to see one of my favorite cities. So let me give you guys a quick tour of Boston. Except instead of walking around showing you things, here's a really shitty dance routine me and Richard made up.
Back in the days on the boulevard I landed, we used to kick routines and the presence was fitting. It was I, the abstract,
and me, the five-footer. I kicks the mad style, so step off the frankfurter.
Yo, Fife, you remember that routine that we used to make spiffy like Mr. Clean?
A tidbit, a smidgen. I don't get the message, so you gots to
okay.
Run the pigeon.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
You're on point, Fife.
All the time, Tip.
But then grab the microphone and let your words rip.
Now here's a funky introduction of how nice I am. Tell your mother, tell your father, send a
While we were out dancing, I did realize something. The city was pretty much completely empty at night, which gave me this great idea.
Okay, the plan is simple.
Take the cart.
Take the cart, walk away. Take the cart, walk away. If the cop asks what we're doing, we tell him we're shopping.
Oh, that's a good one.
That's a good one, right?
Okay. We got him.
We got him. Oh, shh. What is that? What is that?
So this is when we ran into a slight issue. So you see this yellow thingy? It basically locks a tire whenever you try to take a shopping cart out of the zone of the grocery store. But for what I wanted to do, we needed a shopping cart. So let me introduce you guys to Project Borrowing a Shopping Cart so that we could tape fireworks to it and ride it down a main street in Boston at 2 a.m. The title's a little long, but it's still a work in progress. Since we wouldn't be able to ride this shopping cart, I did have a backup idea. Since only one of the wheels had a lock, all we would have to do is take a single normal wheel from one shopping cart and then replace the locking wheel from another shopping cart. So that's exactly what we did.
You like Stratego with the knee.
God, you're gonna hate. I don't think this is working.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck. Let's go. Holy fuck.
Luckily, those cops weren't looking for us, and about 45 minutes of trying to get the new tire on, we finally got it. After that, the plan became a lot easier. All we had to do was drive an hour across state lines to buy fireworks, since you couldn't get them in this state, then tape all the fireworks to the cart, and we are finally ready to execute project. Borrowing a shopping cart so that we could tape fireworks to it and ride it down a main street in Boston at 2 a.m. Feels like, you know, it feels like the world is ending constantly when I look online, but we're just biking and listening to music.
It's just like this, like, you know, the whole like meditative, like presence thing.
Yeah, like being in the moment.
Yeah, I can't figure out how to do it.
Oh really?
Like, no, my mind always wanders to something. Like I go, you know, I sit down, I think, and then all of a sudden I'm like, shit, I got work to do.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. No, I get that.
But like when you're. Like when we were on those train tracks, or like when we were just like freely biking down that like road,
yeah,
or a bridge, I was just like, this is nice.
That's what I was saying. When we were just when we were biking down that, listening to music and just vibing, I was like, this is it, man. This is the start to a good adventure.
Are you talking about like the stress that you like, you're stressing or anxious?
Yeah.
Me too. Yeah.
This whole thing about like living in the moment, and when you're in the moment, you're not thinking about other things that are bothering you. You're just. Having having a good time.
That was a memory, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's just like so nice.
Memories are things you like live in the moment and you don't realize like this is gonna be a good time.
You don't remember what you were thinking in that moment. You remember enjoying a moment, but you don't remember the like a bad thought. So you know, when I think back at like old memories, I don't think of the bad thoughts I had while I was on that trip. Like I think of only the good moments.
Good moments you don't know are happening until they're gone.
Oh, that's so true.
So there's a whole idea of like a fleeting moment and realizing you're in a moment and then realizing, oh shit, this is gonna end at some point. That's, and that's a really sad thought. That's a really sad thought to have. Shit, now we're all thinking about it. Well, shit. This isn't good.
No, not at all.
Do you know how to change a tire? Okay, wait. We don't have a...
Wait, there's no way.
Did I just pull it off?
I don't know how to get the jack out. What is this thing?
Oh my lord.
Help, step bro, I'm stuck in the back.
Help, step
bro. I got it. Dude,
oh
why
my
is
God.
It so... Shit.
I mean, I guess it's a good thing that your tires are really in there, right?
Can't they just make them looser next time?
Oh my god.
I realize that most adventures come with these slight inconveniences, typically involving my car, and either you can let these get to you and ruin a night, or you can just laugh it off and move on. I mean, it already happened, and there's really nothing I could really do to change that, so why let it ruin my mood?
The jack looks like it's gonna break.
That's what I'm saying. Oh, wait, the car's moving.
I gotta go! What do I do? Kick it!
I feel like if you kick the jack out. Oh my gosh, you're scaring me, dude.
After a good hour and a half, we finally got my spare on, and not even a full 24 hours later, this happened.
Guess who just got a $90 parking ticket?
What type of karma did I do? Because I feel like I haven't done anything. Because I barely did anything in 2020.
Right.
Despite these inconveniences, this adventure was already turning out even better than I initially imagined. What I pictured in my head was just kind of going with the flow of things, having very deep and meaningful conversations with friends and strangers.
So now that we're up here, I have a very important question to ask.
Listen.
What's your favorite color? I've known you for so long and I don't know what it is.
I don't know, I've never really had a favorite color.
You're telling me you've never had a favorite color.
I mean, I guess I default to green, right?
Green is like not that.
All right, you know,
not that creative of a color, dude.
Actually, no. How about? Actually, I think I like purple.
Purple?
Yeah.
I knew it. You're always wearing purple, my dude.
Your favorite color is red.
Maroon, to be specific.
Okay, I mean.
Maybe you try to be more specific next time.
What are you, a color?
I am. I know colors. There's a lot of them out there, at least six.
No, but on a serious note, it's only been 2 weeks, and this has already been one of the best times I've had in a while. Not only was I traveling, but it felt like I was actually living again. And with that being said, I'm finally kind of excited to see what the future holds. So I hope you guys stick with me on my adventure.
We should go get the fuck out of here.
Oh my shit. That was so terrible.